routine on the way there. We have to go through it. And every single day, every single meal, three times a day, same over and over and over and over and over again. And we got road rage in here, too. You know what I'm saying?
The changes to the prison have improved security at Hayes. But that may come with a price. Greater tension among inmates. Tension that has already found its way to the surface. Less than 1 year after the escape, inmates in D building took a violent stand. They forced the shift officer to abandon his post as he attempted to lock them down for a routine count. Inmates barricaded themselves in and vandalized the building. But after 2 hours, the prison special response team stormed in and took back the dorm. The balance of power shifted that day, if only for a short time. And now, the inmates at Hayes are planning another face-off. Another test of the prison's ability to keep control.
The county MLM man just said, hey, Nick, if you end up doing some time, go to the fire department.
This fire station is one of the busiest in Georgia's Department of Corrections, and it's manned by the inmates of Hayes State Prison. It's just one of this prison work programs, designed to provide job training and a lifeline to the outside world. Even for inmates like David Crow, who will never see that world again.
I work for it. I used to wake on my detail at office. If I can work seven, I would. There's an awful lot of percentage of the population here that does want to do something positive and to get something other out of this time and out of this experience that will benefit themselves in the long run.
David Crow has a unique perspective on doing time, the result of nearly 20 years spent on death row. In 1989, Crow was convicted of a grisly murder and is sentenced to die in 2008. But 2 hours before his execution, his sentence is commuted to life without a chance of parole, and he is sent to live out that life at Hayes.
When I first got here, I almost felt as if they had just turned me loose. Even though it's in here, even though it's in Hayes, even though it's miserable surroundings, it's still life. It's no different for me in here than it is you on the outside. Our life is what we make of it. Right now, I'm just choosing to make each day the best that I can.
Work details like this are a privilege in Georgia. Crow, who makes glasses for inmates across the state in the prison optics shop, has earned a spot here through good behavior. He's one of the inmates who's chosen to do smooth time, a relative minority here at Hayes. And now, a rumor is circulating that could threaten that way of life. The prison has uncovered